Now we've done a lot of work. You've learned how to identify the instance variables of a class, how to provide the methods, how to write the constructors, and the result has been a lot of code. But we've forgotten something very, very important. How does one use this code? And who's one? That would be the programmer, who doesn't want to know what goes on inside the car class, but who just wants to write programs that drive cars around. Now for a car, one would have an owner's manual, but for code, what you want is Javadoc. Let me show you what one needs to put into the code to get the Javadoc. Over here, you see the same car class that we've been developing, but I've added documentation comments. These comments are enclosed in these delimiters. You see them over here. You see another set over here. At the top of the class, you see a class comment that describes the purpose of the class. At the top of every constructor and of every method, you see a method comment. For every parameter, there is a line explaining what the parameter means. And for those methods that return a value, there is a comment that explains what the method returns. Now, previously, you have seen the Javadoc comments in a web page. The way to get such a web page for your own classes is to run the Javadoc tool, which we can easily do from within BlueJ. In the main BlueJ menu, pick Tools, then Project Documentation, and you'll get to see a web page in the familiar Javadoc format that contains exactly the same comments that were in the source file. That's what the Javadoc tool does. It takes the comments from the source file and puts them into the web page. For example, here you see the description of a parameter, and that's the exact same description that was provided in the source code. Notice that over here this method looks rather naked. No description, no parameter description. Ah, that's because there is no Javadoc comment here. So it's your turn now. Go ahead and put it in.